quickly, euthanize the news.
Hello and welcome to yet another exciting edition of a favorite online TV program, Youth Weekly on UTV Africa, a program that brings to you news that made the headlines within the week in the language and the perspective of the youth. My name is Makinde Tinola.
My name is Ayodele Ayomiposi. These are some of the news that made the headlines within the week. FG to establish agricultural extension offices in all local government areas.
Lagos Consortium agree to construct 844 billion naira fourth million bridge.
Varsity is set to produce 800,000 tons of tomatoes.
Court dissolves 17-year-old marriage over house built by wife.
Buhari's 1 year, a colossal waste, says fireship.
And on the foreign news, Nigerian man becomes mayor in Greenwich, London.
African business leaders are more positive compared to their global peers.
And on the sport news, Ibrahimovic backs Mourinho to bring success back to Manchester United. These are some of the news that make up the headlines within the week. Join us again as we take on some of the pressing news that make up the headlines.
Youth Weekly, youthanize the news.
We are part of the solution.
We bring you youth perspective on issues. Youths have a voice.
We have a story to tell.
Youth Weekly, youthanize the news.
Welcome back. If you're just joining us, this is Youth Weekly on UTV Africa, and this is our discussion section. And looking at the things we've seen from these news headlines, I think I'm quite excited with this agricultural extension.
Yeah, the headline you talked about, the federal government trying to plant some.
Yes. They having offices in local government areas, I think it's going to provide job creation. It's going
employment opportunities are very important. It's going to increase the GDP of the economy because our focus will no longer be on crude oil. It will now also be on agriculture.
I think this is a serious outcome to young people to start pursuing this opportunity.
Of agriculture. There will be more loans, there will be more grants towards. There's a scheme some months ago to female farmers.
Okay.
So this is going to encourage more females in participation of agriculture.
That's a backup to yes.
You know.
I know
there will be an allocation of budget to this. So no matter how the allocation of budget given to this agricultural sector, it's still going to fly.
Although the minister is complaining that
every minister wants to have plenty of budget.
Agriculture is, we're saying it should be the first thing.
But do you know something about agriculture? If you little investments yield a lot of harvest. Like if you have a plot of land to plant something, you're going to yield more increase on that, depending on the facility and all those things put in place. So we should use this as a trial version.
If you call it a trial version, money.
Agriculture. It's going to work. I'm so positive about this.
I don't just seem to just agree with the fact that we should try little percentage. Like we have 1.6%.
Okay, are you saying that 80% of the budget allocation should be to agriculture?
30% is not a bad idea. We want it to be the first thing on our priority
list. It depends on the plans and the budget for the economy for the year. So we can't really.
We hope the next budget is going to find a way to address
so let's
this.
Let's see how it goes.
And that is quite important. Mm-hmm. You were sharing something about.
About a Nigerian man that became a mayor in Greenwich in UK. I mean, he's a 59-year-old man. Yeah, definitely he's been in that field for a period of time, But it's so intriguing that he was a born Nigerian citizen and also a British citizen, that kind of thing.
So he's been in London for decades.
Yeah, but he's not the first African man that will be elected a mayor.
I think one of the things that I like about
it is interesting that Nigerians are actually thriving all over the world.
They're thriving. They're thriving. And that shows.
So there's more to you than what we can see now. That's what you're saying.
I don't have to say it.
Okay.
I'm not saying it. There's more.
Well, there's more to me.
There's more to me. And one of the interesting things about the man is that his places of interest is quite intriguing.
Youth related.
And he even had to say, Kennedy, that the youths are getting to a point where they're not asking what the community would do for them.
Exactly. Do you remember what we talked about from being the needy to being the needed? That's exactly how we couched it. He commended the youth in trying to participate in community things without waiting for that platform to do something.
When he went to London, it was quite young. It's been
young,
a few decades in London, and that's
what I talked about consistency.
consistency. It's important for us to know that there's nothing you do and there is no how you do it that doesn't tell over time. The more you spend time on it and the more better you put
moreover,
your energy.
Moreover, you said practice makes perfect.
So young people should keep and pay attention to whatever they are doing. It's either going to bring a positive result or a negative result, but we expect that whatever you're doing should be positive. Concentrate on it and there are more outputs that you're going to get from what you're doing now. This is as much as we can take today. For further information, follow us on our social media platform, like our Facebook page and Twitter. My name is Ayodele Ayomibose.